It was the closing chapter in a story which has resonated the world over. In a packed church in Johannesburg, friends and family gathered to say goodbye to Nkosi Johnson. Among the mourners, his foster mother Gail, who had cared for Nkosi since he was two. The 12-year-old South African succumbed to AIDS last weekend after a lifelong struggle with the disease. During his short life, Nkosi became an outspoken champion of others infected with the virus. As a voice for the legions of South Africans living with HIV and AIDS, he came to symbolize their fight for treatment and recognition. But while he raised awareness, Nkosi's wish to confront President Thabo Mbeki remained unfulfilled. The South African leader, whose reluctance to offer life-saving drugs has drawn fire in the past, failed to attend the service. Instead, he sent a spokesman with a message of encouragement.
He has left you now. He has left you physically, but he has left you with work to carry on. And I'm sure, with your love and your own commitment, you will carry on the struggle that you started with your son.
We now commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
In a country where more than 10% of the population is HIV positive, Nkosi's passing has raised the profile of AIDS sufferers as never before. Those closest to him will be determined to ensure that his death should not be in vain.